Hello, you're watching Proactive. Cobra Resources has released results from reanalyzing drill holes from historic drilling at two prospect at its Wudinna project in South Australia. Joining with more is the company's CEO, Rupert Verco. Rupert, good to speak with you today.
Hi, Stephen. How are you going? Thanks for having me.
Always a pleasure. So, Rupert, can you put some context around these rare earth results and the grades being reported?
Sure, Stephen. So the results represent historic 96 historic drill holes. And these results from these holes cover two of our key prospects, being Clarke and Baggy Green, and represent a significant area. And the results demonstrate that we have a significant increase in our rare earth mineralisation footprint that's demonstrated by a high portion of these holes. So of the 96 holes, 89% of the holes return significant intersections with considerable widths. So the average intersection width is over 15 metres at an average grade of 530 ppm total rare earth oxide. It's also worth noting that the historic samples were composite samples, so downhole composites of up to 6 metres. And some of these composites sample over geological boundaries. So there is the potential that these results are carrying some dilution and there is great upside in the presented results. But regardless, this now demonstrates with previous drilling that we have done and reported last year, 126 holes that's now defining a significant rare earth footprint of around 4 square kilometres. And that footprint is still open in multiple directions.
Rupert, can you explain the significance of the spatial association between rare earth mineralization and gold structures?
Certainly. So one of the unique and complementary components with our project is these rare earths are occurring within the saprolite clays directly above and proximal to defined gold resources and gold prospects. And what is unique and what we're finding as we increase our data set with our rare earths is there are direct associations between rare earth grades within the saprolite and our mineralized gold structures, particularly at Clarke, where there's structural complexity that's controlling the gold mineralization. And what we believe is happening is that structure is acting as a catalyst for increased weathering and the mobility from the bedrock of rare earths and the absorption to the clays. So that enables us to target key gold targets going forward, like north of Clarke, for both rare earths and gold.
So next steps include metallurgical testing. Give us some context around that work.
Certainly. So we currently have a number of samples from two drill holes from our 2021 drilling in the process of being tested. And what we're testing for is two of the key styles of mineral occurrence within iron absorbed clay deposits. So there are three types of rare earth mineralization, being iron exchange, colloidal, and mineral phase. And the first two phases, iron exchange and colloidal, represent the low cost extraction techniques. So they're more amenable to leaching and are less intensive and less complex flow sheets for recovery. So our baseline test work is testing the recovery potential of those samples under those typical leaching conditions. So once we have these results, we'll hope to be able to further optimise recoveries through establishing more sophisticated test work.
Well, I hope you'll keep us posted on any new developments. Thank you very much for the update today.
Certainly. Thank you, Stephen.
That's Rupert Verco, the CEO of Cobra Resources.